Shanghai GDG is a very interesting developer community.
I'm glad somebody has asked this question.
And this is where the magic happens.
This is primarily a question and answer show. So if any of you out there would like to ask questions.
Hi, everyone. We're back for another Google Developers Live talking about Google Drive. And today we're going to do a app review on ASTRO File Manager. I'm Stephen Basil. And
I'm Alan Bung Suvan.
And yeah, so this is a great app. This is one of the first mobile applications to actually launch on Drive. It's a file manager. It's been around for a while. They have actually a lot of users, tens of millions. And just recently, about a week or two ago, launched version 4. It's a complete redesign of the application and includes things, and not only just a redesign for the ICS and Jelly Bean styles, but also support for cloud services, including Google Drive and Dropbox. We'll take a look at that in just a moment. Do have to get here. I do want to show you the landing page, the Play Store entry for this application here. And you can actually just see some of these are the older screenshots for the application. Just, you know, launch a few of these. You know, it was a good app, again, very popular. But I just want to give you a sense for kind of what the old style of the application is before we jump into the new one. So let's actually go switch over here. We have it up. I do have to apologize. We are in portrait mode. Landscape mode. This app does look a little bit better in portrait. So if you do have a Jelly Bean device and you want to try it out and explore it, you can do that. But this is the landing page for the application. A few features I want to point out before we dive into the Drive specific functionality and how they did this. And we'll talk a little bit more about Android development for Drive as we go through this. But in addition to having some, you know, very high level functionality here for accessing your files, you know, by organized by type, so we can see, you know, documents, music, pictures, videos, my files. These are actually all just built-in searches that will find all the relevant files for you. And the cool thing is we'll actually do this across all your different sources, whether it's an SD card, Google Drive, Dropbox, or any other network location that it happens to work with. It does also have some built-in tools that make it a little bit more powerful than just a file manager. You can see card usage in terms of utilization, what directories and files are taking up the most space. A task killer, not something that you need on newer versions of Android so much, but there for people who do want to go in and you know, just force kill different things, and of course an application manager as well. And if you swipe in the other direction, we can see all the different locations. We have our local storage. We can access network locations on over Wi-Fi, Drive, Dropbox, and again these built-in searches here. So, pretty useful. And, I'm just going to click on music here just to get a basic idea of, what this looks like. We can see here it's finding, different audio clips that are on my device. We can actually change this into a different view. Thumbnails for music, not very useful. Let's go back to here. And how about we'll do pictures instead? So pictures is something that works much better in grid view. You can see the default thumbnails here, but these will fill in as it goes through and scans those files. So these, most of these are actually on my local device here. We can go over and look at Google Drive functionality directly. So I'm gonna go and actually have this hooked up to my Gmail account. And we can see here it's going to start to load. It is a little slower than accessing an SD card, of course. That's to be expected. But you can see here it's actually already started loading the content. We have thumbnails for different images. These are little characters I made for a barbecue we're having. Mm-hmm. PDF files, zip files, images. Basically, these are using, you can even see here for the PDFs, we're actually getting the thumbnail images as well. And these are basically images that are generated by the Drive API. And you know, we'll thumbnail as many of these images and documents as possible, and they're just taking advantage of that to give a really nice presentation here. Using the app is, let's go find a nice little Google Doc. I think I have in here a nice Drive demo folder. Let me see if I can get to it here. And we should have some docs that, let's try this one here. So you could open that file, and I think this is a Google Doc. Or maybe it's not. How about my resume? I believe that is one. Maybe running into a little technical glitch here. One thing I do have to warn you, this is a, it wasn't a Google Doc either. This is actually just a Word doc. So I actually just launched the built-in, you know, document viewer for this. It can go back. Basically what I did want to find was a Google document. Basically what this will do in the case of, you know, whether it's a Google Doc or spreadsheet or presentation, is actually launch that with the built-in Google Drive app. So very useful. And Alon, you had done a presentation on integrating Android apps with Google Drive back at I/O.
That's correct.
So what are, I know we've been a little bit slow to get out one of the services that people have been waiting for, the Google Play services.
Yes. Still not launched yet. So the Google Play services has been announced at Google I/O, and hopefully should be available shortly. It's a new set of services that will be coming to Android devices starting from Froyo, and it will provide a set of APIs that will make it easier for developers to authorize the application to get access to some Google APIs such as Google Drive. So right now, the only way to get an access token, well, there are two ways. The main one is using Account Manager, but the token you get back is not linked to any API project. So because of that, the Drive API has no ways to know which API project is requesting access to which files. And the Drive API introduced some new set of permissions, like an app can only request access to files that it has access to. Or the user opened with these applications. And because the account manager doesn't let Google Drive knows which API project is requesting access, the API won't work when requesting an access token with the account manager. So I believe what ASTRO is currently doing mm-hmm. is using the old API, which is called the document list API, I guess version 3.
I believe so as well. And it does have some disadvantages for mobile devices. So you know, some of the features like partial retrieval, so you can be selective in terms of the fields that you download, is not available in that API, but it is in the Drive API. Actually, really important for mobile apps in terms of minimizing bandwidth usage. So taking advantage of, you know, things like gzip compression, selective retrieval of fields.
JSON metadata.
Yeah, exactly. The JSON is just a lot more compact to begin with. I'm really anxious to get them onto the new API once those Play services are released.
Yes, me too.
Yeah, but they actually did a really good job. The nice thing is that the APIs are functionally very similar, that you have the same type of metadata, access to the same thumbnails, downloading files is pretty much the same, regardless of which API you use to actually search for the content. So it shouldn't be that difficult of a change for them to make. And again, something we're really hoping to see once those services are fully available. So I do want a couple of little features in the app I want to show. Let's do so we can do long presses on different things here to bring up you know, thing. We can actually copy files. move, trash. We can actually send these off to other applications, and this is just using the regular Android intent. You could actually send a drive file to Google Drive. Not sure what that would do. But they also have properties. So you can see here the name, path to the file, MIME types, and everything. So this is pretty useful. There are some things that might be useful for them to add. So one of the things that's missing in here is you really can't take advantage of Drive's sharing features. So we have in the API the ability to manage the ACL, set the share the file with users or groups. That is not something that they have exposed yet through their UI, but it is available in the native Drive client for Android. I'm a little torn personally as to whether or not I would recommend them actually recreating that feature. It is a lot of work to build an ACL dialog and pull in Google contacts and the circles and from Plus and all those different sources of information about who to share with. Yes. One thing that would be interesting is for example, for web applications, right? We have a sharing dialog that's embeddable with JavaScript. I think it would actually be kind of cool if we could do something similar for mobile applications.
Yes, like provide an intent from the Drive app to start the sharing dialog for a specific file.
Yeah, it seems like that would be a really great feature. I know when you did your presentation, you talked a lot about building viewers and editors for Android, and yes. It seems like that would be something to have that share dialogue embedded in that mobile application, that native application, as you're working on the file and as you're thinking about who to collaborate with.
Yes, I agree. So for many of you might not know, but the Drive app on Android has an OpenWeave integration, the same OpenWeave flow we have on the Drive web UI. So you can click on a file, and if Drive doesn't know how to open it, it will prompt the user with a dialog showing applications that can respond to this intent. And this works the same way as the Drive web UI. So it will authorize the app to get access to the file and then open the app with either the file ID if they're integrated with the intent or the content directly as a blob. As Steve mentioned, it would be nice for the Drive app to also provide an intent to be able to share files from another application. That lets another application start the sharing process for a specific file.
Yeah, definitely something that would be a great feature, and I think we'll have to file a feature request on our side to see that in there. Overall, I'm really happy with this application. It's file managers are kind of one of those things where it's not something you use every day, but since I've had ASTRO, since I've been working with these guys, I do find more and more occasions to use them. Particularly great when using applications that download files. Sometimes I have files in my download folder and my SD card. I want to move those into Drive. I've actually used that a number of occasions already. A lot of times when I uninstall applications, they leave behind files. It's a great way to go back and clean them up. So it's not an everyday utility, but it's a really really well done. I love the new version of this application. And as mentioned earlier, it is right now only available on devices with Jelly Bean. And I do know they're planning on rolling out ICS in the near future. It is really new. There still are some kinks in there. But I know the guys working on this. They're hard at work making this just a really awesome app. And there's not a lot of features that I think are missing. Other than things like the Drive sharing and other features like that.
Do you know if they use the revisions feature? Like, can you get access to another revision of a file?
That's a really good question. And I don't think so. Let's actually take a look at, how about this one here? So I know they have some Google Drive functionality. These are just shortcuts and properties. It does not look like it. And if it is there, it's not necessarily obvious how to get to. Mm-hmm. But yeah, that's actually another really good suggestion is accessing revisions. That would be something that's very Drive specific, though.
Yes, that's correct.
Although Dropbox actually has revisions as well. So for the file systems that have it, that would actually be a really, really cool feature to add. It's a really, really well done app, and it's again one of the first mobile apps that's it's super deeply integrated with Drive. In a lot of cases, you could use this in lieu of the actual native Drive app. If you happen to work on local file system and cloud file systems together, it gives you a nice unified interface for doing that. I'm trying to think. Any other suggestions you think would be really useful or features?
I'm thinking when the Google Play services launch, it would be nice for them to migrate to the Drive API, and I believe it will make things a lot easier for them for the long run. Like dealing with JSON metadata instead of XML, using the lightweight client libraries we do provide for Java and Android. All of this will make a lot things a lot more easier for them and for developers in general.
Yeah, definitely. And again, for the performance improvements of just having a lot smaller payloads is really important for mobile devices. I think a lot of developers are looking forward to having the Play services out there. I know there's a ton of other mobile developers we've been chatting to you about Drive, and they're anxious to get started. I think that's all we have for this. Again, you can check out the app if you have a device with Jelly Bean on it. You can just download it from the Play Store, give it a try with Drive and Dropbox and just stuff on your SD card. And if you like the app, give it a review in the Play Store. I think it's really solid, and really enjoy working with these guys to make it a great app.
So. Great.
All right, we will be back on Tuesday, is it right?
Monday,
okay. Be back Monday. I don't know what the topic is, but you can check out the schedule on the Developers Live site, and we'll make sure that's updated for Monday's topic. Great, thanks.
Bye.
Shanghai GDG is a very interesting developer community.